consolation final between North Melbourne and Collingwood. Collingwood holding a slight lead after Lee Carson kicked four beautiful goals during the third quarter. As the ball has bounced, it's Dempsey and Moore. Peter Moore winning out. He's just about best on the ground so far in the match, but the last quarter could count. Craig Davis, hand passes, a bad one over towards Schimmelbusch, up towards half forward, and the mark taken by Glendinning, who has moved to half forward after half time. So Ross Glendinning has a chance to bring up his first goal, his second goal. He's already kicked one about 50 metres out on a slight angle. Then he comes for the kick. Going very close, it could be through. It's a goal. Great start for North Melbourne in the last quarter, and they're starting off as they did in the third quarter. So on Seven's Big League, the score, Collingwood 11 goals, 17-83, North Melbourne 12-6-78.
Well, that's the second goal North Melbourne have received through a bad mistake on the part of Collingwood. Davis gave the hand pass out there to Schimmelbusch. In the third quarter, we saw Magro give one out to Doug Smith.
Elimination final, a minute and a half gone in the final term.
Set a bounce again. Dempsey gets the knockout. Schimmelbusch goes for the punch. It's Blight fumbling the ball, but gets a hand pass over to Wilson. North Melbourne back in business again, up towards their full forward position. Sutton at the back, but McCormick tapped that one, and it's out of bounds in the forward pocket. That was a bad mistake by Davis that time, but I suppose it's not hard to mistake players with the stripes as they got, because when you're in a bit of a panic out there and everyone's around, you can easily give a wrong hand pass out. But still, it's caused a goal for North Melbourne. Doug Smith and Moore. Little Schimmelbusch trying to get out of the pack. He's in trouble there, and the umpire said dropping the ball against him. He's not too happy about it. The free kick to Olsen. Oh, it's a high kick. It doesn't travel much distance. Off the top of the pack, Lowe tries to spin out, but he fumbles the ball. Picked up by Keith Gregg. Comes back on his right boot. Shoots it up towards the full forward zone. Punched away by Moore. Bright is going after. The crowd go after him when he goes for the ball. A hand pass back to Darryl Schimmelbusch. He's grabbed again. Back to Bright. In trouble. Back to Bright. This could be a goal. But he's up target and he's put it out of bounds on the foot, and a penalty free kick down there to Collingwood's Olsen. At the moment, it's 5 points the difference in favour of Collingwood. Collingwood in the last two quarters have started off badly. It's about halfway through each quarter. They've come home and played very well. I wonder if they'll do the same thing this quarter. North Melbourne off to a great start so far, kicking a goal. There's Moore at the back of Dempsey. Couldn't hold the mark. Dempsey gives a hand pass. The umpire said he threw it to Schimmelbusch. It'll be a free kick to Ray Byrne. He's out there at half back. Oh, it's off the side of his boot. A chance for Laudermark. He fumbles. Lowe's kick get a pounce on the ball. A long hand pass. Not a good one. It bounces the wrong way for Lowe. And then we see the fumble that time by Law, but he recovers pretty well to pick it up and get it away from the danger zone. Down there towards centre half forward. Tapped out again. Back towards Peter Moore. He fumbled the ball. They're all fumbling. And there's Schimmelbusch. He can't pick it up. And there'll be a ball up out there at half back for Collingwood. Let's say it's about 60 metres out from the North Melbourne goal. 5 points the difference in favour of North Melbourne. Moore and Dempsey, they've had a great battle. Knocked out by Dempsey to the wrong man. Picked up by Olsen. The ball back out there towards half forward. In comes Davis. Knocks the ball over. Kink pounces on it. Picks it up well. A left foot kick down there towards Davis at the back. But Dents is there and he takes the mark. The umpire says it's a mark. Well, I don't think Davis had a kick yet. He may have had one little hurried kick, but he's been a very silent player today.
Very ordinary player. Collingwood can't replace him with anybody, though, because Weirmouth and also Edwards off the field injured. Over the boundary line it will be, and the throw-in to take place on the centre wing, about 10 metres on the North Melbourne side of the centre. Huge crowd here this afternoon, round about the 100,000 mark. Ideal conditions. Dempsey and Moore. Down towards Schimmelbusch, almost threw it to Malcolm Blight, right in front of the umpire. Back towards full forward it comes. Ireland knocks the ball down, goes to Jarrett. Here's danger to Collingwood. Jarrett shoots out the hand pass. Peter McCormack's there, though, defending well for the Magpies. Magro. Oops, almost offloaded. In fact, he was a little bit too slow. Stan Magro to get rid of it on that occasion. Barham got ironed out by Keith Gregg with what I thought was a fair bump.
I'd go along with that, Pete.
And it's going to be a free kick to Ricky Barham at the right half-back flank. Law and Kink. Dacos, too slow to get rid of the ball. Low tackling his opponent, Henshaw. He fell on top of him. Free kick to Henshaw. And Collingwood have certainly had the better deal in the free kick department after half time, but this time it is a free kick to Ross Henshaw, who decides to give it to Malcolm Blight. He's been fairly quiet today. Blight hasn't done that much. They all missed that sun in the eyes situation. Peter Moore again. He's best on the ground, no doubt about it. Looks for Domburg. Domburg is at centre wing for Collingwood. They go under attack for the first time this quarter. Up towards Davis. He still can't do anything right. Ramsey's there. Or an educated kick towards the boundary line, and it goes over for a throw-in on the right half-forward flank. In fact, it's a little bit closer to goals than that. It's almost in the forward pocket. As we await the throw-in, Atkin and McCann, the North Melbourne ruckman getting the front position and winning it well. Well done, Stephen McCann. Good ruck work to see the ball back towards centre wing. Dempsey has the ball knocked away from him, only into the arms of Keith Gregg. Gregg coming to life in the final quarter with a long kick down towards the full forward position. Brightus is there with Morris. Morris goes over. Brightus gets the ball on the hop. In he comes, fires it, goals. North Melbourne in front of it's a goal. It is. Brightus' third goal. So in Seven's big league, the score, Collingwood. 11 goals, 17, 83. North Melbourne 13-6, 84.
And that's at the six-minute mark of the last quarter, a point the difference. And that's how this game's been all day. Nothing in it at all from the word go. Can the Magpies come back like they did in the second and third quarter?
Just over 6 minutes now gone in the final term.
Waiting for that centre bounce. It'll be Moore once again against Dempsey. They must be getting sick of looking at each other, these two, because they've been at it all day except for about 10 minutes. Knocked out by Dempsey, picked up by Shaw. Shaw gets a kick down there towards the half forward line. A chance for Rene Keke. He taps it out there to Carlson, who kicked four goals in the third quarter. And look at Carlson go, but he can't pick up the ball. Picked up by Law. A hand pass back to Ramsey at half back. He goes for a short pass looking for Blight. He's got the mark. McRow downed him.
And he what? Went down like a sack of spuds. And could have his number taken.
I don't think so. I think the umpire's talking to him, but. Of course, Brightus fixed up Weirmouth in the first 3 minutes of play, but looks as though Blight's okay. Been a pretty solid game without anyone doing something silly except in the early part. Let's see what Blight can do. He's gone for a short pass. And there we see Casson left unattended, and he takes the mark. A hand pass. Oh, it's a bad one over to Shaw. And Shaw boots the ball back there towards half four to mark to Stephen Eck. North Melbourne starting to get their second wind again. They're looking a bit better again, as they did in that second and third quarter in the early part of them. There's a chance for Glenn Denning. He fumbled the ball. He's got it there. No, it's Dempsey, I should say. And Dempsey takes the mark. The crowd not too happy about it. But Dempsey's claimed it, and he's kicking the ball well up there towards the full forward zone. Moore and Glenn Denning. Moore's got the mark. And he's played a great game for Collingwood today. Moore's got the mark at fullback for Collingwood. There's a point the difference in favour of North Melbourne at the moment. And we're at the seven-minute mark of this last quarter. Chance for Rene Keke. He takes the mark out there at halfback. He quickly plays on. Not a very good kick. Looking out there for Davis, who hasn't touched the ball all day. Let's see where the dough is grabbed. He's trying to get clear. Now he's clear. Kicks the ball back there towards the full forward. Lowe comes in. Can't pick it up. Grabbed by Stephen Eck. A good hand pass over to Henshaw. And North Melbourne take the ball away from the danger zone. Back into attack. There's Peter Moore once again to take a mark at centre halfback.
Well, if this was a game in which Brownlow medal votes were cast, he should get about six. The maximum is, of course, three. But what a game he has played. Certainly Collingwood's best player. And if Collingwood lose today, it will be no fault of his. Gary Dempsey, his opponent, then taking the mark. Dempsey is at centre field. A mark to Smith. No, says the umpire. Morris tries to go through, got caught, and then was pushed in the back. So Kevin Morris must get the free kick almost at the full back position. Collingwood vice captain. Back towards Kink. Very quick to get boot to ball, Rene Kink, towards the half forward flank. Davis is there, so too is Henshaw. It bounces better for Davis. Now he's coming into his own a little bit. That's two kicks in the last minute and a half. And Ick running with the ball, takes the mark. That was a good grab. Ramsey right at fullback. Short passes to Keith Gregg. That's okay, and he takes the mark in front of Barham, who wasn't limping then, but didn't seem to be running with as good as he could. Gregg now from left halfback. Ireland in front of Doug Smith to take the mark. Collingwood behind by 1 point in this elimination final. Trying to get the ball moving quickly, and they get it to Peter Moore, one of their faster players. Moore towards the forward pocket. That's a mark for Lowe. Lowe has the mark for Collingwood and has a chance to level the scores if he can only just kick 1 point. But of course, Collingwood need goals, but what a difficult shot this is. You can see the goals there in the background. Lowe right on the boundary line. The distance should be no problem. But accuracy certainly will count. Ian Lowe fires at the goals, and it's gone through, I think. Wait for the goal umpire. 4 points, Collingwood back in front. What his first goal for Collingwood, and it couldn't have come at a better time. On Seven's big lead, the scores, North Melbourne, 84 points, and now they trail Collingwood, 89 points. That's what I like about life. Yeah, that's the thing about me.
It's nip and tuck. Collingwood under Hafey, North under Barassi for the last finals campaign. And there's just a kick in it.
What a great game, Peter.
What a great goal.
What a great goal. And actually, he was on his wrong side for a right footer, but he put it right through the middle. The moment it left his boot, there was never in doubt.
10 minutes gone now in the final term of the elimination final at the MCG.
And the Magpies in front by 5 points. Once again, it's Peter Moore and Gary Dempsey. Back it comes towards Moore. He got the knockout, but not a good one. Grabbed here by Wilson. A bad hand pass out towards Ricky Barham. He looks as though he's got a bit of a limp up there too as he finally kicks the ball well down there, looking for Lowe again. He's got it. Oh, golly, Lowe's got a chance to put him 11 points in front. And this is a Footscray reject too. Footscray dumped this guy and he came to Collingwood. And there was a bit of criticism about his selection the last couple of weeks, but by golly, if he can kick a couple of goals here, they'll carry him off the ground.
Well, it'll be a very valuable goal if he can get it. It'll restore their lead that they had at three-quarter time.
There's the shot by Lowe, and that's right through the middle. It's 11-point lead to Collingwood again. 13 goals, 17-95. To North Melbourne, 13-6-84, and we're at the 11-and-a-half-minute mark of the last quarter.
Ian Lowe striking a purple patch in the final term with 2 goals. Lee Carlson had a purple patch in the third quarter when he got 4. And so Collingwood playing in patches. Can they go on with it from here? 12 minutes gone in the final term of the elimination final.
Back to the centre again. It's once again, it's Moore and Dempsey. Punched away, but it went to Dempsey that time. He fumbles. He gets a hand pass out to Schimmelbusch. Scoops it up beautifully as the ball goes up there towards full forward. In comes Goober, but that's a darn good mark to McCormick. He's been a pretty solid player all day there for Collingwood. McCormick goes out wide, looking for Moore. Moore flies, he's got the mark, and what a game this guy's played. As Peter said before, if there were Brownlow votes around today, he'd pick up about 10. Peter Moore at half-back. Boots the ball back there towards half-forward. Renee Kink in the back seat, couldn't get it. Tapped down here to Dench, a hand pass to Jarrett, back to Dench. Dench coming right down from full-back over to Casson. Back to Dench again. Can he kick a goal as he runs towards the goals? He fires, but it's up target. Up there and through for 1 point. And he hasn't played a bad sort of a game either. David Dench, he's only got one leg, actually. He's got a bad knee. So it's 10 points the difference now.
85 players, 95. Peter McCormack has done well at full-back, and so too has David Dench at the other end of the field. Ball out towards Dempsey and Moore. Dempsey with the fist from behind, got it away from a Collingwood Brownlow medalist. Glendinning to Sutton, good teamwork. Oh, Collingwood player caught one right in the head there. That was Magro. As Wilson breaks away for North Melbourne, steadies. Bad defence by Collingwood. He shoots it at the goal. 1 point. Oh, he had time to steady too, Wilson. He wouldn't be too happy with that shot.
I see that Magro's in the hands of the trainers.
Yes.
They wouldn't want to lose him, Pete, because they're two interchange players are out of action. But knowing Stan the man, he'll be back on his feet pretty quickly, which he is.
Well, for Collingwood's sake, I hope so, as we're with Peter McCormack now, who this time comes around the members' stand side. In front is Davis, behind is Keith Gregg. It goes past Magro. Jarrett missed it. Ireland grabbed. We're not in possession. Must get a free kick. Andrew Ireland at centre-half back. Or tending towards the flank, actually, but Ireland will get Collingwood out of the danger zone momentarily towards half forward. In front is Law, scooped around the back. Shaw's there, intercepting is Dench. Dench to Law, good football. Law's played well today, incidentally. Daryl Schimmelbusch is at centre wing. A short pass towards centre half forward finds Rodney Wright, who got 3 goals in the third quarter. Wright a long way out from goal, and a 15-metre penalty. I didn't see what that was for, Lou. Did you see?
No, I didn't spot that, Pete. I think he may have gone over the mark, tried to creep up a bit that time.
Well, it will bring him within scoring distance, about 35 metres out directly in front, coming in for goal number 4. I think off target. Goal umpire says 1 behind. So that's a bad miss by Wright. That's 2 he's missed in the last minute that both could have been goals. So on Seven's big league, the score, we see North Melbourne still trailing 86-95.
And it's out there towards Byrne. He takes it away from Schimmelbusch, and Collingwood go back into attack, approaching the 15-minute mark, and the ball is out of bounds on their half-forward line. It'll be about 70 metres around from their goal. Well, Collingwood in front by 8 points at the moment. Been a real tough match this. I think the biggest margin all day has been 11 points.
That's right.
So that just shows you the evenness of these two sides. They've been great rivals over the last few years. Knocked out that time by Atkin. The umpire's found a free kick. It'll go there to McCann. And incidentally, he's been a pretty quiet player today, Peter.
Yes, he hasn't shone as we expect of him. He hasn't taken those big marks that we usually see.
There's the kick by McCann. It's a short one. Byrne goes for the punch. Dentz overruns the ball. There's the chance now for Collingwood's Davis. He's had three kicks this quarter. The ball falling short. Ramsey dropped an easy one. Davis snaps, pounces on it. A shot for